Let's welcome Professor Dr. Kafisha, Dr. Mumtaz.
Thank you very much, Luqman, for this introduction. And I would like also to express my honor to be with this group of distinguished officials and professors of international law. Let me just say I'm honored to be with and to thank Ambassador Waleed Abu Ali, our ambassador in Malaysia, Mr. Ammar Hijazi, His Excellency, and Minister Waleed Assaf, and Professor Rahmat Muhammad, and Professor or Dr. Azil Muhammad Amin for being in this webinar. Let me start by from the end, where my colleague, Professor Rahmat, ended. And I would like to focus in this 10-minute presentation on the technical challenge that facing us, those who are representing or defending Palestinian rights at the ICC. First of all, I would like to say the 5th of February 2001 will be remembered as a historical day. I think the question of Palestine before that date is different from after the 5th of February. This is a landmark decision which would have a far-reaching results or effects with regard to the question of Palestine. Subject matter of this session is the impact of the ICC decision on the recognition or the international recognition of the state of Palestine. I would say that notwithstanding that this decision is a legal and judicial question, but it has, I think, direct and indirect impact on the question of recognizing Palestine as a state. And this is one of the first or the first item that has been decided by the court, that Palestine is a state and a state member to the Rome Statute and therefore to the ICC, and it has specific and determined borders which are within the 1967 occupied territories, namely Gaza, the West Bank, and East Jerusalem. As I mentioned, I would focus on the technical challenge because I work on this file on behalf as the chairman of this session indicated, on behalf of the Palestinian Bar Association, along with other colleagues, including my AXA Foundation, which I also thank them for their submission that they presented to the International Criminal Court. From that experience, I concluded, and I think our colleagues at my AXA and others concluded that the journey in dealing with the ICC will not be an easy matter, because we have a very sophisticated opponent, or the other party, the Israeli party. Although Israel is not party to the Rome Statute, but it mobilized all its contacts around the world, especially in the United States, Europe, and in Israel itself at the official level, in coordination with the 7 governments at least, and several NGOs and many distinguished international professors to defend Israel. We took this issue, the question of jurisdiction, as something that we take for granted. For us, it's very clear that Palestine composed the West Bank and the Gaza Strip, including East Jerusalem. But that question was not an easy thing to convince the court of. Even one of the judges, Judge Kovas, was not convinced that of our argument. And this brings to the fore the question of investigation and the many crimes that has been committed and still being committed in the occupied Palestinian territories. As we know, that Rome Statute punishes for crimes. But in fact, if we break these crimes into different acts, you could see that there are about 70 crimes or types of crimes that could be punished by the International Criminal Court. And to prove each of these crimes would not be an easy matter, because as we know, the international the ICC prosecutes individuals, doesn't has jurisdiction over states, it has personal jurisdiction over individuals who commit war crimes on the territory or territories of state parties. And in the near future, hopefully when the investigation opens, Israel will not save any effort to convince the court and to convince judges who are not specialized in the question of Palestine that there are legitimate reasons from the Israeli point of view to undertake these actions that we consider as war crimes. Just to mention a few examples that other speakers hinted to, the question of settlement, the question of apartheid, the question of blockade on Gaza, the question of the separation wall, the question of home diminution, the question of Palestinian prisoners, including administrative detainees. Many of the crimes, Israel does not consider them as crimes. First of all, it would deny that these acts has been committed or have been committed in the occupied Palestinian territory, and it will have lots of justifications to convince the court that has the court should not decide on these matters. Israel not only sophisticated in terms of military and the politics and contacts around the world, but it also has many intellectuals and many scholars, and Professor Rahmat and other professors who work in international law know this. On each issue that we write or deal with on the question of Palestine, so, for example, the question of the right of return, the question of Palestinian borders, the question of water, the question of the wall, Israel recruits lots of scholars to write, or even these scholars by themselves, as they are Israelis or they are pro-Israel, they write numerous publications at the international level. The other day, I was just looking for some articles. That I'm recently writing an article on the question of the special law pertaining to Palestinian refugees. And I was looking for some articles regarding right of return. I found one of the legal databases that Dr. Rahmat knows, High Online database, just two articles defending the right of return to the Palestinian right of return. And on the other side, there are like 20 or 30 articles dealing with the question of the right of return. The moment that Palestine acceded to the Rome Statute, over, as far as I know, over 100 articles and books has been written on the question of the ICC and its potential jurisdiction on Palestine. Most these articles were written. I'm of course, mentioning the articles that are written or have been written in English. Written by either Israeli professors or professors pro-Israel. And that is very, very important for international courts, because judges in the future, when they would deal or discuss or deliberate any issue or a crime that would be alleged before the court, they will look at the international literature on this. And unfortunately, most of this literature in English has been written by pro-Israel scholars. And I'm saying this because we need, I think, as Palestinians and those who are supporting the Palestinian position at the ICC, including my AQSA and many peace and human rights activists around the world, that we need really to be prepared. The real work has just been started now. And of course, I know that the Palestinians since 1967, we are working through many Palestinian NGOs and a number of Palestinian institutions, including the Commission on the Apartheid War and et cetera. We are working on documentation, etc. But as from my experience as a human rights officer at the United Nations, the human rights work and the documentation for the purpose of human rights violations, although it has some similarities to the war crimes on the issue that would be brought before the court, I think it would be substantively different. And as a professor also of international criminal law, I could see how many gaps and different ways of interpretation that can be invoked when we come to the Rome Statute in addition to the elements of crime, the question of procedure, the question of evidence, regulations of the court. The issue is very, very, I would say, complex, that needs lots of technical expertise. And I think with all due respect to the diplomatic level that Palestine has dedicated for this question so far, I think the technical work, now the time is for technical work. Just to let me give you one example. Last Tuesday, just 2 days ago, one lady from the old city of Hebron, living in a settlement called Daboya, she's a Palestinian living in her land. And since 1984, several Israeli settlers were immigrated to that place and lived around her house. She lived in the Hebron city center. And from the city center to her home, it takes 5 to 6 minutes to reach her home. Now, in order to reach her home, she needs at least 2 hours to go to her home. She faces every day lots of harassments from the settlers, including breaking the windows of her home, burning the trees, the olive and grape trees around her home, humiliating her and her nine members of her family. She came to my office and gave me a power of attorney to represent her. She said, "Motaz, you are an international lawyer. You represented the Palestinian Bar Association. Please represent me. I have been under attack by the Israeli settlers for around 35 years, and no one could give me justice. Everybody knows about my case, including members of the U.S. Congress, of course, the Palestinian authorities, the Hebron Construction Committee, which is a committee that is responsible for the reconstructing the old city of Hebron. But no one until now could be successful to give me justice. I told her, okay, give me a power of attorney and I will see what I can do. But I told her, I can't promise you of anything because I know the challenge is big, because this lady, her name is Hannah Hekel, is just one of about 30 Palestinians living in that old city of Hebron, which is completely under Israeli blockade. And its residents face every minute, I would not say daily violations, but every minute violations, including home demolition, including humiliation, including beating, including breaking their property, etc. In order to work to represent this lady, I think I need at least a team of 20 international law specialists.
Montas, can you conclude?
Just in 1 minute, I will conclude. In order to convince the court of this issue, because even for me as a Palestinian to understand her case and to write its facts and bring all the evidence relating and the witnesses relating to this case, I think it would be a very big file that needs, as I said, a team of lawyers to work. And of course, we can, from this instance, we can think of many, many crimes and acts that are committed on daily basis, as other speakers indicated, including in Jerusalem, near the apartheid wall, the home demolition, the war in Gaza, etc. So we are, conclude, we are at the moment of truth, and I think Palestinians and our supporters around the world, we would need to put set up a strategy in order to deal with the issues that would be raised before the ICC when the investigation is open. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Dr. Mukhtar.